Hello students, welcome to class 12 biology. This is the first revision session for your biology class. So for this biobotany, for this week test you will write in biobotany lesson 1. So name of the lesson, asexual and sexual reproduction in plants. So in this first part is quite familiar to you. In the second part you are going to write test that I will discuss those answers, how should you write. So you just, if you are having the book, you can just have a look at these pages, that is where 1.5.1 is given. Double fertilization and triple fusion is one of the important questions. Why it is called as double fertilization? Male gamete has got two nuclei, both are involved in the fusion. You can see here the pollen tube is developing and it goes through the style to fertilize the ovary. Follow? So that is how this endosperm will be formed. See, endosperm is 3N, so zygote is 2N, so the endosperm will be 3N, which will feed the growing embryo. So the second gamete migrates to the central cell, which fuses with the polar nuclei. So polar nuclei is present in the ovule. So then the fusion product, the secondary nucleus, forms the primary endosperm nucleus, that is what is called as PEN. Okay, since this involves the fusion of three nuclei, so generally fertilization involves only two nuclei, here it involves three, so it is called as triple fusion. Okay, that is one of the important questions. Then you have the endosperm and what are its uses. It is most important question. So what is endosperm? Definition is given here. This full paragraph will form definition for you for the endosperm. Okay, so the primary endosperm nucleus is a result of triple fusion. Okay, so it is a nutritive tissue. And what is its role? Then the types of endosperm is described and functions of endosperm is most important. Okay, how they help in the development of the growing embryo. Then coming to the embryo, dicot embryo, and then the seed. So once all these post-fertilization changes occur, the seed will be formed. What are the parts of the seed? Funicle, hilum, micropyle. I think you know the definition for all these terms, testa, tegmen. So if you describe all the term only, it will form the structure of dicot seed. So for the structure of dicot seed, you have to draw these all these diagrams to explain the structure. So you can see cotyledon, plumule, radical, testa, tegmen. Okay, so all these diagrams should be there for the explanation of dicot seed. Okay, so then you can see here, this is most important, figure 1.22, development of dicot embryo. So all the stages along with A, zygote, B, two-celled proembryo. So this diagram alone will be asked for 5 mark question for you at this week test. Why? Because any one of the diagram will be given to label the part in your examination. All these diagrams are most important. At least for 1 or 2 marks you will get this question. So you have to draw all these diagrams and label the part. Okay, so you can just have a look at the diagram of the mature embryo and you have to draw the seed, mature embryo in the seed. Follow all the diagram, zygote, 2-cell, 4-cell, globular embryo, heart-shaped embryo, mature embryo, mature embryo in seed. Only diagram for 5 marks. Okay, so then we have another question about the parthenogenesis. Okay, and its significance. What is parthenocarpy? How this parthenocarpic fruit formed? And what is its significance? Okay, so these are all the most important questions of the second part of the lesson. You just go through. I think I made it very clear. Only diagram for those stages and endosperm function and then definition and parthenocarpy definition and also the significance. Double fertilization, triple fusion, both along with the diagram you have to explain. Okay, so that's all for your first revision biobotany class. Thank you, students.